But for my muffin.
I'm not Chappers!
And I am the captain.
I'll scream it. It would be really fun to scream it.
I'm the captain!
Yeah, that was awesome. Well, that should be our new thing every single time we start a video. We should just scream our names.
Holy mothers of Mary.
Back in the day, there was a company called Dodd.
Dodd. See, yeah. Many of you guys who are similar age to Rob and I will remember the days when all you could buy in a guitar shop if you wanted a pedal was probably a Boss pedal or maybe an MXR pedal. But if you remember, there was one company that was a sort of little thorn in their side, and that was Dodd or DOD.
Yeah.
I never remember if it was Dodd.
We always called it Dodd, but I think it was DOD.
I think it may have been DOD.
And you know what? I did wonder if Zach Wilde wrote Destruction Overdrive after Dodd. Because I always wondered what DOD stood for, and then he came out with Destruction Overdrive. I thought, oh, I wonder if it's Dodd.
Maybe it's that. And then I don't know quite what the history was. It either morphed into Digitech, or Digitech bought Dodd, or something. But for a long time, Digitech became the sort of, they were the ones that had all the glory and all the pedals and everything. And Dodd would just leave a couple of sort of classic pedals. I know Yngwie Malmsteen has sort of always had like a Dodd distortion thing.
But keeping it real, bro.
They're keeping it real. They're kind of back with a couple of cool new guitar pedals from 2015. One which they've designed all on their ownsome. And again, to sort of be a bit old school, which is the Gunslinger.
Yeah.
It doesn't get much better than that, is it? Well, actually, maybe it does.
Feel like I should have my BC Rich. But yes. Unfortunately, I've given it away to somebody.
I saw that on YouTube. You just gave it away, didn't you?
Yeah, gave it away.
And then the other one is called the Boneshaker, which they have made in conjunction with Black Arts Toneworks. So I don't know if you've heard a little bit of the jam that Rob and I were just doing. If you haven't, maybe you'll hear some now. But basically, in this jam, I was using the Dodd Boneshaker with this Strat into this Victory, pretty clean amp, and Rob was using the Gunslinger into a sort of a driven sound
on
this amplifier.
Well, we say driven, it's actually on Overdrive 1, and on Overdrive 1, It sounds like this. Ready?
Yes.
3, 2, 1. How does your amp sound?
So, you know, mildly sort of crunchy, I suppose. But let's stay with Rob's pedal for a minute. So the Gunslinger is a MOSFET distortion with four controls, a gain control, a volume control, and a bass and a treble control. It's a passive EQ circuit in there, so it's a real kind of old school drive sound.
I really like it.
Yeah, we really liked it. We liked it more over a slightly dirty channel, but just to give you the full
comparison. Because it
sounds
a bit thin on the clean channel.
This is how it sounded if you... This is just no pedal. It's got a real nice harmonic-y sort of sustain-y
feedback. It's quite piercing though, isn't it?
Bit piercing, and that's why I think we like to...
He's still beast.
It might be just because the Victory's driven channel is a little darker anyway. But so, here's without. And this is where we thought it sounded great. So, and if I just fiddle around whilst Rob's playing, you can see how it kind of goes from a low gain to a high gain sort of setting.
Sounding 80, it's very 80.
Yeah, it's got sustain.
I think it's probably why I like it. It reminds me of the days I spent locked up in my dad's little studio with one of those rack Marshall JMP1s. Yeah, and two powered 1x12 Marshall speakers, and then about 10 of these second hand from my mates. This kind of thing, you know, it's great.
Back in the day.
They were days. Guitar.
Naughty. So that's the Gunslinger. Now, that's for those of you that just want your technology old school, Gunslinger is way to go. If you like your technology a little bit more current, then we've got the Boneshaker. Now, I'm going to just plug. Can you stand by your? Stand by your amp.
Stand by your amp.
I'm just going to plug. Oh, I've said that. I didn't do my own. I'm just going to plug the Boneshaker into Rob's amp so you can get a sort of a good comparison.
Boneshaker.
So now, the Boneshaker is, just plug these back in. So the Boneshaker has a lot more gain on it, but the gain goes into fuzz rather than into that sort of classic sort of amp distortion.
Should I clean my amp up then?
No, let's just see what happens. And then EQ-wise, we have got a 3-band parametric EQ. So if you're unfamiliar with that jargon, it means that the for each of the tone controls, so low, middle, and high, there is the outer ring adjusts the frequency that I'm going to
just ultimately like
adjust.
The metal zone.
Yeah, exactly. And the middle control does the actual level of that. And because it's active, I can boost or take away, unlike a passive circuit where it's really all about sort of taking away. And then there's this other control in the middle called depth. And Dodds say that this is particularly good if you're using low tuning. So either drop tune, 6-string or you know, 7 or 8 strings or something like that. So, but as I said, it does have a tendency to go sort of de la fuzz, which is what it's supposed to do. Okay. So let's get some tones. Start with the clean sound and let's see what happens with it over a clean.
What happens is a lot of volume.
Sorry about that. Finding it just a smidgeon thin still.
Ah, see, no, I'm hearing that with a band.
Oh, are you?
And it's cutting through like a cheese knife.
I'm sure it probably is.
We'll do that. But I like that. I was really getting into it.
So let's see what happens if we go a little bit gainy on the amp and then start low again here. Noisy.
All of my available guess.
Yeah, you went like that as well.
Like this plus this in this equals profit. It just
well,
sounds
good
great.
For Dodd.
It sounds great.
Yeah, I guess perhaps I'm just a child of the 80s, but I did like the Gunslinger. I wonder if this is just more that sort of. Is this stoner rock kind of?
Well, yeah. That's what I was kind of trying to get into the vibe of. It felt like that. It reminded me of kind of. Quats and also, you know, Caius and sort of good music.
I want to try this Gunslinger now through this amp.
Gunslinger, buddy. That's the Jovi pedal for you, man.
It could be. Could.
That's all your white slate licks, that is.
That's proper. Yeah, so you see, I think you're probably more at home with that, or maybe, I don't know. Well, let's jam out with that then, because there's not much else to really say about these,
no.
Is there? They're in
well,
the
how
shops
much are
now.
They, sorry?
85 and 159, 139, 159.
Okay. 159. Great pedals, nicely constructed.
Nothing wrong with that, all
they
true
look
bypass.
Really cool, they've got great names, they sound awesome.
Yes.
And you want to play a little bit of
why not?
Doomy Sludge? We'll be right back. damage. Nice.
I need a Wawa. I need a Wawa.
For
that, some of those licks.
Yeah, for that you need a Wawa, yeah.
It's all British.